I'm going to show you how to create a path blur. So this is really interesting. It's a new addition to the blur gallery, and it enables us to put objects into motion across paths and different shapes. So here we go. We've got Lena holding my Ibanez. I would never let her really swing this around and start smashing things up in the studio. But I can definitely make it look that way. So let's go under the filter. We're going to go down to the filter here, and we're going to go down to the blur gallery. And under blur gallery, we're going to grab the path blur. So now here you'll see this little path. And what you can do is you can change the direction. So you just drag this, and what it will do is it'll change the direction of wherever we want that motion to happen. So we can change the speed here. And we can also change the taper. So if you want it to kind of taper off, we can do that. But let me turn it off here. What I'm going to do is I actually want to make it look like she's swinging the guitar around. So you can actually grab the center point, and we can pull this out and create a little bit of a curve. So let me bring it back to about there. And then let me bring the speed down a little bit so you can see it better. So it looks like we're kind of swinging the guitar a little bit. But there's other features that we can do in here. If we turn on the edit the blur shapes, with the blur shapes, we can literally go down here and we can exaggerate the movement by hitting these little red points here. See that? So we can really kind of change that up. So you can see there, we can do all kinds of things. Notice how it's blurring the entire background and everything with it. So these are just kind of really interesting little shapes here. So let's get this where I'm going to bring it down a little bit. And I just really want to kind of have this guitar being swung. So I'm just going to pull it down more this way. There we go. It's looking pretty good. And just bring that in. All right, so we've got some movement happening here. Let's play around with the taper a little bit and the speed just to kind of get it where we want it. Now, obviously, we've got this kind of swinging around, but we've got all this blurring going on with her, too, so it's not too useful right now. So what we're going to do is I'm actually going to protect this area. I'm just going to click once to add a new tool. So we're going to add another blur, and I'm just going to grab at the bottom. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to use this one here to protect the rest of the image. So this is what we do. We go over it. We select it. And I'm going to hit the control key, and you'll see this little symbol. Double click, and that will set that to zero. Let's go down the bottom, do the same thing, double click, and that'll set it to zero. So what we've done now is essentially is we've protected this area here. Now we can even bend this so you can allow some of this other blurring to kind of creep in there a little bit. And it kind of makes it look a little more natural. If I move this over, you'll see how the blur will start to affect different parts of the photo. Let me just pull this over here where I'm not protecting it so much anymore. There we go. So what you want to do is just kind of come in here, find an area where you feel like you've got a good balance where it's looking a little bit more believable. So here it's kind of looking quite believable, and we've got the guitar swinging. Now I can change this. Let me bring it up a little bit more, and I'm going to bring it this way. So we just maybe even bring it up a little bit more here. And I'm going to pull that midpoint up there. So now it looks like more of this swing is happening from there. But let me bring it in. There we go. So you just want to kind of experiment with this a little bit until you find the right settings for you. And this is actually not too bad. I feel like if I just click OK now and apply this, we can see we've got a little bit of motion there now that's happening as if she's swinging that guitar. And of course, you know, there's no guitar is harmed in the making of this. Now, the other way you could do this too is you could actually just start with the unblurred layer, duplicate the layer, add the blur to the duplicate, and mask it. In fact, why don't I just revert this right now, and I'll show you the other way of doing that right now, just so you can see how that works. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to revert this image back to the unblurred one. I'm going to pop this on the top, and then we're just going to choose the filter. We're going to go back to the blur gallery. And I'm going to go back to the path blur, and I'll show you what we're going to do here. We're just going to add our blur just quickly, and let's just grab it like that and increase the speed a bit. Okay, so we've got that movement happening now, and I'm just going to click OK. So we've applied it, and now all we're going to do is create a mask, but I'm going to hide the mask. I'm going to hit the Option key and click, and now I'm going to create a hidden mask. Now all I need to do now is just paint in with the white, and I can paint in the blur exactly where I want it to work. So I'm obviously going to use a much smaller brush than this. And you're going to bring your opacity down so you can kind of build it up. So we're going for a little bit more realism this time. So what I'm doing is I'm just painting the movement onto the top part of this guitar. And there we go. We can see where it kind of looks like it's moving now. And just maybe a little bit on her. And we're able to use the mask now to create that movement. So it's a little bit more subtle. We could even go down here a little bit more. Actually, let me undo this. What I'm going to do is bring it down a little bit more, and I'm just going to kind of paint it up here. So we've got the movement happening on the guitar, but mostly at the end. There we go. And I'm going to go down this end and paint it out a little bit too, because if she would be swinging it, she'd be swinging it from this end as well. So we've got the areas where the motion would be happening now, maybe a little bit in the arm here as well. So now what we've got is the motion happening where motion really would be happening, and the shoulder, maybe a little bit in the hair, so it's kind of moving, flying around a little bit. There we go. So now it looks like we're swinging this guitar, and personally, I think masking it this way, I can make it just a little bit more realistic than I can directly inside the blur gallery. So lately, I've been hearing from a few cafe crew who said they're members of Photoshop Cafe, but they haven't subscribed yet to the channel on YouTube, and they thought they had. So maybe that's you. Just check out, make sure you hit that subscribe button right now. Become part of the cafe crew, and every week you'll get a brand new tutorial. So thanks guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit that like button right now. Don't forget, add a comment. And this type of training also comes from a video I have. It's a Photoshop CC for digital photographers. It's a 13-hour comprehensive course that will teach you everything you need to know about working with photographs inside of Photoshop. So anyway, thanks guys. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.